Have you ever experienced two seasons wage war with one another? Winter and spring were the opponents, and the Tecumseh Trail was their battlefield. Only one would prevail. Chad and I arrived at Morgan Monroe State Forest late on April the 20th, with an increasing blanket of unexpected snow that had crossed the Midwest. This was only the first encounter that we would have with Old Man Winter before we ended the Tecumseh Trail and its 45 miles of hilly terrain across southern Indiana. The forest canopy had a clashing beauty to it the next morning. The dainty, rosy pink blooms of the red buds looked like they were trying to be snuffed out by winter's last icy grasp of the year. All the ephemeral wildflowers seemed as if they were sprouting for the second time this season, first from the awaking earth, and now again from the white frozen lace.
Thank you.
The snow was quickly melting and showering us when we reached the natural rock shelter. It was nice to be under its protection, as the former flakes now dripped into the creek bottoms. The snow became as ephemeral as the wildflowers near our feet, disappearing into a lucid memory, now replaced with the elegance of bluebells and youthful fiddleheads ready to sing us a sweet song. We were just getting settled into the spring backdrop when winter returned for its second assault. We were pelted with icy pellets as we approached the first backcountry shelter.
This is crazy!
What is it?
Not April! Ow, it hurts!
It became a cherished bunker for us as we braked for lunch. The assault was short-lived, and spring seemed to arise victorious as she garlanded our heads with sunshine. The landscape we traversed through seemed as confused as we were by the strange weather microcosm. More dark clouds approached, and we braced ourselves for another onslaught of Arctic ammunition. The anticipation of reaching camp was palpable. Although we didn't know it at the time, that would be the last we would see or hear of our wintry foe for the remainder of the trip. The day's battle we fought made the Fox Den shelter feel like a haven for us, filled with food, fire, and fellowship to garnish the remainder of the evening.
Surprises me though.
Yeah.
Never think that that's a thing that should happen.
Oh, you hear the farther away one too? Calling back.
Thank you.
The next day began to the songs of many joyous birds, relieved to have the bite of cold and dreariness behind them. We shared in that joy as we pressed onward to Yellowwood Lake. This trip was quickly becoming a story of contrasts for us. The previous day's harsh notes of white were replaced by the vibrancy of every hue imaginable, from the forest floor to the canopy peak. Chad said it was like seeing the colors of fall in reverse, and he was right. We had gained some significant elevation when we approached Charlie's shelter, which was like a camping castle along one of the ridge tops north of Yellowwood Lake. We stopped and had our lunch there, feeling like royalty.
Thank you. grab them.
Bodies were yearning for camp when we approached the inlets of Yellowwood Lake. We stopped long enough to soak in the rays and the lulling tide, and then pressed on to Black Gum Campground.
I assume this doesn't need to be filtered.
You know, I was just thinking about that.
I just wanted to ask you, like, are you going to filter your... body weight and gear will press it down the rest of the way. baby.
Chair's sinking in the mud over here.
Oh, yeah. Steal away. Pretty sure I've stolen from you multiple times on this trip, and probably every trip I've been on.
That's how these things go.
Life rarely feels sweeter than when surrounded by the primal bond that a fire brings to those sharing its indelible warmth. We retire to our tents, feeling grateful.
As good as it looks.
I think I need to let it cool down some. It's too hot to taste right now.
Chad and I had settled into a comfortable groove by the third and final day on the Tecumseh. We had reached that point in an adventure where conversations lessen and are replaced by the transfixing effect the miles of trail has on your psyche. We let those miles flood over us as we trudged south towards the town of Belmont.
Thank you.
man, Chad is going for it. He's taking a rock and he's leaving a sock.
My backpack. All used. Put it on here with these Mardi Gras beads. Find a nice looking geode.
You have a winner?
I have a winner.
Yes. I'm still in disbelief. We just met Mr. Sean Bowman. He has just completed the new FKT for the Tecumseh Trail. What is your time?
Yeah, just finished in 6 hours and 35 minutes. See right there.
That is amazing. Dude, congratulations.
Thanks,
that
guys.
Is a, an accomplishment.
Well, guys, congratulations to you. Got about a half mile to go.
Oh, all right.
That's awesome.
And, we'll see you guys on the trail.
Yeah, absolutely.
Peace.
Deep in a hollow near Panther Creek lay the sign marking the end of the Tecumseh Trail. We stood valiantly by its side, leaving no doubt that spring had won the battle and was here to stay. This trip etched into us the importance of the changing of seasons, both for the earth and for our lives. We left those hardwoods, eager to see what this new season of life would bring us.
Thank you.
Filming me, filming you, filming a blooper. Hello. He went for that cycle.
Yeah, he did.
Continuity.
Oh man, I messed up my continuity by doing that.